I am extraordinary.
Yes.
Man, I am still the only Akira Yoshida Mitchell human being sitting in this couch in the whole world, I guess. So I am still, I am an individual in this world, but still ordinary. Ordinary life, ordinary heart, ordinary happiness. Ah, this is really curious because I'm really uncomfortable with changes before they happen. And I very often I freak out a bit, like, okay, now I'm so attached to seats, to my classmates, to this environment, to the studios, to... But at the same time, whenever I change my spot to another place, I feel really welcomed and really easy. I go to my hometown, then I feel like, wow, this is amazing to be here. Like, I'm with my friends, I have sun, I have tortilla de patata, I have my family, my house, my bed. For me, it's really like, I think I live a lot in the present moment, so once I arrive to this present moment in this present place, everything is easy. It's like, I'm here, okay, this is perfect. Well, usually I don't like so much this feeling. Like, if I feel different, I feel sad sometimes. Then maybe I start to judge actually this, maybe it's a bit contradictory, but I start to judge a bit this, like, ordinary feeling of... And then I don't feel extraordinary, but the opposite. Like, I don't know. But I guess everybody has these same trips inside, I guess. But it's just when I leave it in my skin, then I feel it a bit like, okay. Maybe sometimes everybody is so open to talk with each other in the cafeteria or something, and then I feel like, I don't talk to anybody. And then I feel like, but actually this is what I feel like doing. But at the same time, I feel like, should I talk to people? Or like these kind of really stupid things. And then sometimes I feel like, did I miss a certain social ability during my life? I don't know. But of course it happens sometimes, and I think it happens to everyone. But as a different? No, I think... And then it's more me who I treat myself differently, or who I get this thought of, shit, I feel different to the other people, but not in a good way sometimes. This is the tricky thing. Otherwise, no problem, I think. Yeah, I mean, I'm not afraid of it. No, I'm not afraid of stop dancing. I'm not afraid of it, but for sure I would not like to stop dancing. But somehow, I think like after meeting Julian Hamilton and these people, like, I think, yeah, until I am 75, I will dance. I will find, and I feel also, I did a lot of breakdance, but I don't feel attached to it. I love to practice it, and whenever I come, I have energy, I can, I take some people to train, and I really like the feeling. And it's what I have done for 14 years, but I am not attached to it, like, I can't let it go. And of course, like, breakdance has been my base, and maybe it still is my base. And I will always love it, and I will always be grateful to it. And it will always be with me, like, even if one day I stop practicing it, it will still be my base, because somehow through breakdance I learned to love dancing, because I would just do it with my friends in the street. Like, we would buy the batteries for the radio, and we would just go to the streets to dance. And nobody would think that we could live as a dancer, because in my city there is not much things going on. Plus, we didn't have the knowledge of subventions, money, companies, blah blah blah. So, but we would still train every day, like, as much as we could, and after we would go to eat some tortilla de patata.
I wanna hold your hand.
fun when you're on my mind. Is it really this cool to be in your life? There's one thing I'll do. If it ever goes wrong, I'll write you into all of my songs. And if suddenly I die, I hope they will say that he was obsessed and it was okay.
Akira is somebody really lucky who was born in a very, who got the chance to feel very simple alive sense somehow of, yeah. I think, yeah, Akira is somebody very lucky who was born in a family that supported his life. Not in terms of dancing, this took really long time, but in terms of, yeah, that they wanted me to be really alive and happy. And this really made me feel like alive and happy. And through there I feel like everything got connected. Through catching fishes in the river, to running out of a snake in that village, to doing Trulala Trulala, to going with my mother to a Chinese restaurant, through, I don't know, everything, like, yeah. Also with my grandparents, my two uncles, like, I don't know my Japanese side of my family. Maybe, hopefully one day, yes, but right now I don't have so much time, but maybe. But at least through this side of my family, I felt like they really loved me, and this, I really got it. Like, I got this love fully from them. And this is me, I think.